And now turn to some breaking news that we first told you about at 5 o'clock. It's happening right now. Investigators are on the scene of a double shooting in St. Rock. It happened at the intersection of Elysian Fields and North Miro Street.
This story starts in the 8th Ward of New Orleans. The 8th Ward is a section of New Orleans, Louisiana. It's one of the downtown wards of New Orleans. Neighborhoods in the 8th Ward include the Marigny Rectangle, Gentilly Terrace, Seabrook, Lake Oaks, and St. Rock. St. Rock is the same neighborhood that Deloyd, Puggy, Jones grew up in and was named one of the alleged leaders of the r.o.d. gang. Deloyd was the city's most wanted man twice. He was just 15 when he broke out of the youth study center facing weapons charges. Police said Jones shot a man on North Roman Street in 2009. Later that day, Deloyd and Byron Jones stole a bait car, equipped with cameras and a device that shuts the vehicle off and locks the doors. Jones was arrested and eventually pleaded guilty. He was sentenced to 5 years suspended, meaning he served no jail time. Just days after being released, the NOPD says Jones went on a shooting spree in the 9th Ward. Armed with an assault rifle and a semi-automatic 9mm handgun, Jones and Alton Augustine started shooting, then spotted Lucius Baker, who had left a house up the street on his way to the 1300 block of Gallier Street. Baker was not the intended target. Prosecutors would later find that the 2010 shooting spree was related to an ongoing beef with Gregory Rabbit Stewart. Gregory later confirmed the beef between the two in one of New Orleans' most infamous RICO cases. The witness eventually testified only after the DA's office put him in jail on a material witness bond. The two men identified as members of the Ride or Die gang each received 80-year prison sentences for the February 2010 shooting. Family members of Deloyd Puggy Jones, age 20, and Alton Pee Wee Augustine, age 18, ran screaming out of the courtroom after criminal district judge Linda Van Davis sentenced them both to two consecutive 40-year sentences. While serving the 80-year conviction, Deloyd's name would again be brung up in crimes that prosecutors say that he and 11 other members of the gang committed, including the murders of Corey Blue, Devin Hutton, and Travis Arnold. Arnold's murder was reported by local news.
The officers are picking up the shell casing markings. The scene is starting to quiet down somewhat, but just moments ago, it was a very active scene here in the St. Rock neighborhood. Investigators are telling us they're still trying to piece together the who and the why this happened. But here's what we know so far. Sometime after about 4:30 this afternoon, two men were sitting in an SUV here at the corner of Elysian Fields and North Miro Street when another car pulled up alongside them and opened fire. The two men that were sitting in the car, one was a 30-year-old man. He was shot multiple times. He died on the way to the hospital. The other, the passenger, was 36 years old. He was shot once in the arm. He is in stable condition at University Hospital.
Federal investigators said during the RICO case that the gang used a house in the 1600 block of Mandeville Street as a base of operations to package, sell, and store narcotics, as well as store firearms. They also said that members would tattoo the number 8 in between their eyebrows to show loyalty to the gang. The number 8 represents the ward that they resided in. Deloyd was subsequently sentenced to life in prison on top of the 80-year sentence he was already serving. Byron Big Baby Jones and Sydney Duda Man Patterson was also sentenced to life in prison. The judge granted Deloyd's request to remain in Angola to serve out his new sentence.